In this video, we're going to learn how to set up a voting session in Lucidspark so we can drive action and gain consensus as a team. To create a voting session, navigate to Collaboration Tools and click Voting. This opens a panel where we can add details and provide additional instruction. Let's walk through each of these settings to learn what they do and when we might use them. First, we have our title. And while this may not seem like a big deal for a single voting session, it can be super helpful when navigating multiple sessions. A clear title makes voting results from a previous voting session way easier to find. Next, we have the private voting toggle. By default, this is turned off, but if we were to turn it on, participants would no longer be able to see who voted for what. This could help us remove bias by limiting the influence of others during a vote. However, there may be times where we actually want to know who voted for each object. This information could help us identify individuals who are passionate about an area and might be willing to explore it even further. So it's important to think about what we're trying to accomplish and then make our adjustments accordingly. Vote on current selection lets us specify which objects our team is able to vote for. So if we had a bunch of ideas from a brainstorm, but only wanted our team to vote on specific ones, we could click and drag to select those objects and then toggle this on. And in those rare instances where we need something in between these two, we could use these toggles to specify which items can and cannot be voted for. The next area helps us determine how many votes each participant can have. Our selection really depends on what we're trying to accomplish. If we're only voting on a few objects, then giving everyone only one vote seems to make sense. This way we can define a clear winner. But if we have a dozen items to vote on, it may make sense to provide multiple votes per person. This way we can increase our chances of defining a clear winner versus having multiple items with only one vote. By default, multiple votes per object is turned on, meaning someone could use all three of their votes on a single idea. This adds weight to their vote. So if we didn't want that to happen, then we need to make sure to turn this toggle off. Next, we have the timer. This is an optional setting, but it's a great way to get to a solution quickly. Timers create a sense of urgency and help individuals make decisions before being able to second guess themselves. Once a timer is set and time runs out, the voting session will automatically end. If we didn't want this to happen, we can just click the toggle here. Now, we also have the option to provide written instructions. Not only is this helpful for those joining in asynchronously, but it can also serve as a reminder of what to expect while voting takes place. And now that everything's set up, we're ready to start our voting session. We'll invite our team using the share button or a shareable link, and then click Start Voting. As soon as we do this, the voting panel will appear on everyone's screen. As facilitators, we'll be able to see everyone's votes as they appear. And if we want to participate, all we have to do is hover over an object and click. Once the timer runs out, or when our teams have finished, we'll end our voting session by clicking here. When voting ends, everyone will be able to view the results. Votes will be aggregated, showing the most at the top and the least at the bottom, making it quicker to agree which action to take. If we click here, we can show or hide how many times an object has been voted on. If we need to reopen a voting session because someone missed a vote, we can reopen the voting session by clicking here or create another session by clicking here. That's it. You should now be able to set up a voting session in Lucidspark to help drive action and gain consensus with your team. But this is just the beginning. To learn even more ways you can leverage Lucid in your day-to-day work, visit us at Lucid Training Labs.